Hello, I'm Ernest Carter of the Bluegrass Hymn Trio, and we're proud to be a part of WLJC. We've been coming here, and even back when they had the radio broadcast, since the middle 60s, and it's an honor to represent Sister Margaret and this fine TV station, WLJC, here in Beattyville, Kentucky. And I understand that I'm there just about five nights a week when you're live, and then you have two more nights, seven nights of good gospel broadcasts, and invite you to tune in each and every night here for good gospel music and preaching on WLJC, Beattyville, Kentucky.
WLJC welcomes you to have church with us for the next 90 minutes during the Hour of Harvest. Call in your prayer request or praise report now. The WLJC prayer team is standing by to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to our service tonight. We really hope that you will be free from your work and be able to sit down and just have church with us, because if you've tuned in for the very first time tonight and you are not familiar with what we do here at the ministry, well, our entire project is to lift up Jesus. And so each night we have live, a lot of people call it a church service, and because especially for the shut-ins, this is what they feel like it is. And so we have different singers, different churches from different states, and everything comes in to help us each night. There's a different group each night, and we sing and talk and preach about the Lord, and to share the good news, which is the Word, with the people. And so if you like gospel singing, well, then just stay tuned, because we're going to have, this is a church that's located tonight that's with us, is up toward Buckhorn, up in that direction of the state. And last week we had some from Charlotte, North Carolina, and Chicago, and so we had, each night is different. So if you've just tuned in for the first time, you better have to tune in each night to see if your favorite ones are on, because we have been blessed with a lot of good friends. A lot of people have talent, and a lot of people want to do their work and sing and talk about the Lord. And you know, that is our mission, is to try to help people see that this life, with all the trials and troubles and joys and victories and everything, it's all going to be over one day. And then we are going to meet the Lord, and we need to be ready. Well, all right, we hope you can stay tuned, and we are going to try to read a little bit, but I tell you, I've been to see Dr. Simon today, and I'm not seeing too well, but I will after I get my cataracts off someday. I'll be able to see what I'm reading. So I've got a scripture that I halfway remember, so I hope to get by it that way. All right, the very first psalm. It says, "Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind driveth away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, or sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish." only six verses in Psalms 1. And there's 150 Psalms, and they each one, they're my favorite. And we spend a lot of time in Psalms because to me, it just kind of describes where we are and what's going on better. But anyway, we're going to pray and we're going to believe tonight for His will to be done in this service. And if you can still see to read for yourself, I really encourage you not to let this go by. You know, it's a precious thing to be able to see enough to read and to study for yourself. It's good to hear somebody else, but it's better if you can do it for yourself. And so the only reason that I do it here is for the ones that are no longer able to see, or they're just too sick, they're too discouraged or whatever. It's to help them. But you know, our relationship with the Lord is a one-on-one. We can't get to heaven because our parents lived right. We can't get to heaven because our church is doing well. We're going to get to heaven if we go by accepting the sacrifice that Jesus made for us. And if you haven't done that, I hope tonight would be a wonderful night for you to make that decision. Most of the churches that come in to sing for us, they say that, you know, all through the week, knowing that they're coming, that they've been praying for souls to be saved. And that makes a big difference, because if you're praying and asking and believing, then it will happen. And so let's pray right now. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank You and we praise You for Your goodness. We thank You that You have told us that You know the righteous and You know the unrighteous. And we know that You have promised to be with us and that You will always sustain us. And we thank You for that. And Your mercy is from everlasting to everlasting, to even down to our children's children, the ones that follow You. And we praise You for that, that all of Your mercy has not been used up, but You still have plenty for us. And so bless each person that has joined us tonight and minister to them if they have needs, physical, spiritual, financial, emotionally, or whatever, Lord. We know there's so many hurting people out there. And so as we come together in this prayer, we ask for Your anointing and blessing to be on our singers, on the phone operators, and help us to be able to successfully lift up Your name. And it's in that name we pray. Amen. All right, tonight we have a church group with us from Altro, Kentucky, near Buckhorn, like I mentioned. And it's the Altro Church of God, and their phone number, 606-398-2623. They love the Lord. That church has been going on for a long, long time, I think. And so they love the Lord. And you know, that's what He wants us to do, fill our spot regardless. You know, He didn't just send one person or two people to do all of His work. He wants us to do what we can, be faithful. Some of them have some real testimonies over here. But right now they're going to sing for you, so let's welcome the Altro Church of God.
Lost and lonely within, but with wandering compassion of King of all kings, with pity and love, He took me under His wing. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Child of the King, now His royal blood now flows through my veins, and I, who was rich, yet clothed in His love, and I'm washed in His blood. And someday I'm gonna sing, oh, with the angels above. Oh yes, oh.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Good to be back over here at WLJC tonight. And, always good to get to visit Sister Margaret and Brother Don. They do a real good job here. And I hope the Lord blesses them. Oh, I know He blesses them, but you know, you got a staff up there probably answering phones. And God blesses all of them, you know. We want Him to bless all of them. Every one of them in this station that has a part, we pray for them and want to bless them. Want the Lord to bless them. In Jesus' name we pray. If a man has fallen, brother, pick him up. Tell him about the Savior and His wonderful love. Tell him how Satan has led him astray. Tell him about Jesus, do it today. Tell him about Calvary and the rugged cross, and how the Savior paid the awful cost. Tell him about heaven, teach him how to pray. Tell him about Jesus, do it today. If you are a soldier for the man upstairs, remember the lost sheep in every prayer. Better help your brother who's drifted away. Tell him about Jesus, do it today. Tell him about Calvary and the rugged cross, and how the Savior paid the awful cost. Tell him about heaven, teach him how to pray. Tell him about Jesus, do it today. Tell him about Calvary and the rugged cross, and how the Savior paid the awful cost. Tell him about heaven, teach him how to pray. Tell him about Jesus, do it today. Tell him about Jesus, do it today. Praise the Lord. Sometimes we get kind of... we get started in the wrong key, and they have to find us. But you know, we ain't professionals tonight. We just trying to do something for God, and that's what we want to do. We want to do something for the man above. Praise the Lord forever. Hallelujah.
Number most of all, I want to look upon the Master and sing praises when at last the battle's won. I want to know I've run my race. Your Jesus Savior kept the faith, and most of all, everything down here will dim and lose its value when compared with all the glory we'll behold. But most of all, just to look upon the Savior will make it to heaven if there streets of gold. But most of all, I want to look upon the Master and sing praises when at last the battle's won. I want to know
I'm a holiness child. I'm a holiness child. Well, if anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a holiness child. Well, I believe in the Bible, and I believe that it's right. Well, I believe you gotta live holy and live a good, clean life. Holiness child, I'm a holiness child. Well, if anybody asks you,
sometimes I try to tell what Jesus means to me, and I find myself searching for the word to say just what I mean, but I never can quite describe how good he but I
a father or friend, and on him I can always depend. For I know whatever I need, that's just what he is. Well, I'm poor and needy, but the Lord still thinks about me. In troubled times, he's my high tower and the refuge you see. This world has nothing to offer me. I'll cling to him. For I know whatever I need, that's just what he is. He's my rock and my deliverer. He's my strength, my God and my King. He's my shelter in the time of trouble. Yes, I look to him for everything. He can be a mother, a father, or a friend. And on him I can always depend. For I know whatever I need, that's just what he is.
Woman, don't you worry, for God sent me today. And before she even asked him, help was on the way. Just hold on.
Brighter day is coming for those who Amen. Our hope is in Jesus tonight. Amen. We're glad to be here tonight. We just appreciate the Lord so very much. And I'm going to sing a song that says He didn't stay dead. And I'm certainly glad that He did. And I'm glad that He rose again. And amen. And because He lives, the Bible says we can live also. Our hope is in Jesus tonight. You might be in a hopeless situation at home tonight. Don't know how you're going to maybe make the next car payment, or maybe the electric bill come today. Mine did, and it was pretty high. Maybe you got your electric bill, don't know how to pay it tonight. Why don't you begin to pray and begin to seek the Lord tonight, and He'll make a way where there seemeth to be no way. Come on, Dad. Jesus told His disciples of things to come. He would be persecuted, beaten and mocked. The Son of Man would die on a cross, but He wouldn't stay dead, and He won't stay gone. He didn't stay dead, and He won't stay gone. Jesus is coming to take us home. In the Bible we're told He surely shall come like a thief in the night with the trump of God. The King of all kings who paid the cost. Thankful for the resurrection power of Christ tonight. Amen. Hey, girls. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. We're just honored to be here tonight, and we just appreciate you. We're from the Altro Church of God tonight, and if you ain't got a home church, and we'd love to have you come be with us tonight. And praise the Lord. I would introduce us, but be honest, we really don't matter no way, but it's all about Jesus Christ tonight. Amen. Right here.
When Simon Peter walked over, putting his faith unto the death, he said, Master, will thou bid me come unto thee? Jesus said, come. So Peter went, and when his faith he had was bent, Peter sank low, but Jesus had waves rolling under his feet. Under his feet, yes, under his feet. cannot be. Whenever you waded out too far in waters too deep, remember when the waves are over your head, they're under his feet.
Come on, baby.
Often we faint when trials soar, can't face our problems anymore, forgetting wherever we may go, he's been there before. We should look up and praise the Lord. He walks the waters and the heavenly breeze and the thundering sea are under his feet. Under his feet, yes, under his feet. There's not a problem that you'll face that he cannot meet. Whenever you waded out too far in waters too deep, remember when the waves are over your head, they're under his feet.
Thank you, Lord. Praise your holy name.
Amen. Thank you for Jesus tonight.
They're under his feet tonight. Peter waded out too deep and began to sink. Told Jesus to save him, and he did. He reached out and lifted him up, back up, I believe. My time.
Three rusty nails.
With three rusty nails, they nailed Jesus to the tree. The sun turned to darkness on that day. The day that Jesus died and the blood flowed from his side. The blood that washed my sins away. Now this is a story of long ago, about a man who owned a little store. He said, I was proud to have my name up over the door. It was some 2,000 years ago, as I recall, located in Jerusalem across the street from Pilate Hall. He said, I thought I had anything I would ever sell was in a corner. Three old rusty spike nails. But then one day a big Roman soldier came to the door. He walked up to me. It seemed he shook the floor. Can I help you, sir? I said in a voice I guess it seemed frail. He looked at me with a snarling grin. He said, I'd like to buy some big, big nails. Three old rusty spikes is all I have. He said to me, that will do for the job that I have. Three's enough. How much do I owe you? He put the money in my hand, and I was glad to make the sale. But then I wondered and asked him, sir, what can you do with just three nails? He said, did you ever hear of a man called Jesus the Nazarene? You mean the one who goes about doing good? He said, yes, that's the man. Well, today I intend to show the world that I'm bald. For with these three old rusty spikes, I'm going to nail Jesus to the cross. I stood there almost numb, and you'll never know how I felt. I said, please, sir, don't do that. I'll buy them back as they're on my knees, I kneel. He just turned and walked away. I got up and followed him. In the distance, I could see the Halloween mob as tears fill my eyes. Away with him, crucify him. I could hear their angry cries. Over the top of all the moans and groans of agony, I could hear the sound of that hammer as that big soldier nailed Jesus to the tree.
They nailed Jesus to the tree. The sun turned to darkness on that day. Was the day that Jesus died and the blood flowed from his side. The
Lord, help us tonight. Amen. I'd like to hear if somebody will get saved tonight. Amen.
When I look around and see the good things He does for me,
oh.
Well, use me, Lord, in your service. Draw me near every day. I'll be willing, Lord, to run all the way. And if I falter while I'm trying, don't be angry, let me stay. I'll be willing, Lord, to run all the way. Well, all the way. Well, all the way. I'll be willing, Lord, to run all the way. If I falter while I'm trying, don't be angry, let me stay. I'll be willing, Lord, to run all the way. Many loved ones gone before me, leaves me lonesome as can be. At the parting, at the river, I recall. But I promise the brokenhearted, I'll be faithful till the end. And I'll be willing, Lord, to run all the way. Well, all the way. Well, all the way. I'll be willing, Lord, to run.
Thank you so much. We'll give them a chance to take a little break and get some water. These lights have a way of drying you out. You've been listening to the folk from the Altro Church of God from Altro, Kentucky. That's up near Buckhorn. 606-398-2623. Is their phone number if you would like to get in touch with them about their church services or their singing and whatever. We have a number of prayer requests coming in, and I might say, you know, this is the first month of the year, and we've had some new folk that have wanted to be on put on our mailing list. Once a month, we mail out a little newsletter, and it has different, we share the information that what's going on with the ministry, any advancements and so forth. And then the most popular part of the paper is our guest schedule. Now, sometimes she has them all scheduled down here, and then sometimes people get sick, sometimes for different reasons, they cannot come. So sometimes we have to change from what you find on your newsletter, but there's always a good reason for that, because, you know, I believe that most people realize how important it is when you make a promise to be someplace, you will be there, and because it's just important to keep our word. All right, we'll share some, but if you'd like to be on our mailing list, is what I started to say, is we need your complete mailing address, exactly how you get your mail. Now, if we get it just a little bit off, well, then they mail it back to us. So we like for it to go home. And so if you just call during the day sometime and give your phone your address if you'd like to receive our newsletter. Robbie from Madison County needs prayer, and Kay from Jasmine County. And our little friend Amanda Sexton over at London said she needs strength. Now, I hope she's back home. I have not heard, and this note tonight doesn't tell us much about it, but Amanda has been really sick. Her late husband, Harlan Sexton, went to be with the Lord a few months back, and then Amanda has been in and out of the hospital about ever since. And so she has written a lot of songs, and Amanda's a fine person, and someone has called and says she needs strength. So that will be the way we pray for her. From Pike County, Ken Lee, is only 2 years old and has already had two strokes. So it's a baby and needs some help. From Letcher County, a lady has some financial needs. And she also has cancer, and her son needs help too. Anita from Madison County for her cousin Randy that is sick. Ms. Loudon from Fayette County for herself and family. A friend has called for Pat. It's a church friend and said she's having lung problems and it's real serious. From Somerset, someone named Don needs prayer for himself and also his mother. Eddie has called for Fanny from Johnson City, Tennessee, health issues. And here's one from Berea for Bertha, and that's a blood issue there. Edna from Cumberland, Kentucky, a lady needs a job and needs healing. Earl and Goldie from Mount Sterling have physical problems and need help. Lisa from Florida has called for Jeff and Lisa. They need a touch from the Lord. And also Roger and Diane for health, happiness, and peace. Well, that's a good one. That about covers it all, doesn't it? Luther from Fayette County for Phyllis that has liver cancer. David for Josephine from Marion County, 84 years of age and having some health issues. And you know, that's kind of the way it is. These bodies start wearing out and then we have to kind of keep patching them up and go a little longer. Well, we have more, but we will save these others till the end of service. And if the Altro Church of God singers want to come back, well, we'll let them sing as many as they have planned. And remember their phone number now if you want to get in touch with them, 606-398-2623. And they'll be there to answer your call if you need something. That's the number to do it on. And we appreciate all of you that are calling in that have needs. And I'm glad that you have, that's showing you have faith in the Lord and you know where help is, because all of our help comes from the Lord. And we need to recognize that. Sometimes it's easier to remember that when we go through some hard times than it is if things go smooth for us and we kind of forget to lean on him too much. But all right, let's go back over to the singers and see what they have for us now.
He'd been laying there so long, body racked with pain. Friends gathered round him, they were praying for a change. Said, I hear there's a man preaching in a little house downtown. Water, cry out loud,
When I thought I needed sunshine, the Lord sent rain. When I thought I needed a healing, I had my share of pain. I've been looking for a mountaintop, but a valley's all I see. But Jesus always seems to know exactly what I need. He knows exactly what I need. Oh, to walk the narrow way. Jesus knows how to keep me humble and how to make me pray. He knows when the clouds cover the sky, I'm walking in a valley low. I'll be on my knees calling on Him. There's no other place to go. When I thought I needed friendship, I had to stand alone. When I thought that I was doing right, the Lord said I was wrong. I found I needed a blessing, but the good Lord sent a trial. And now I know just what it means to suffer for a while. He knows exactly what I need. Oh, to walk the narrow way. Jesus knows how to keep me humble.
Just like a big shout out to the church tonight, and amen, we love you so much, which every one of you is with us tonight. And we just appreciate the Lord. I know you're out there praying for us tonight. I've got a good friend named Jesse Graham. I want to say a good howdy to him tonight. Praise the Lord. Two colts were before me, an old and a new, and I could have either. So what must I do? Well, one colt was ugly and terribly torn. The other, a new one, had never been worn. Oh, I'll tell you the best thing I ever did do. I laid off that old coat and I put on the new.
The old coat was dirty and not fit to wear. I thought of it often and shed many a tear. When there was a new one presented to view, I laid off that old coat and I put on. I'll tell you the best thing I ever did do. I laid off that old coat and I put on the new. The old coat was earthly and made of the ground. We bought Mary's image the whole world around. Well, the next was my Savior from heaven so fair. He gave me now see me wham. Oh, I'll tell you the best thing I ever did. I laid off that old coat and put on the new.
This new coat just fits me and keeps me so warm. It's good in the winter, it's good in the storm. My father has blessed me with manna from on high. He gave me this new coat you now see me wear. Oh, I'll tell you the best thing I ever did do. I laid off that old coat and I put on. This old coat was filthy, all tattered and torn. My friend, I had worn it ever since I've been born. Why wear it any longer, just fit it to do. And turn off this new coat Christ offers to you. Oh, I'll tell you the best thing I ever did do. Laid off that old coat and put on the new. Oh, I'll tell you the best thing I ever did. He said I laid off that old coat and I put on the new.
Thanks the Lord. Hallelujah. And ain't nothing like it. The Lord today, boy, it's good to be able to feel the Spirit of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. It's sort of like when Samson shook himself. It must have been sort of that when he shook himself, and amen, and he began to fight against all the armies tonight. I'm so glad to have him in my life tonight, and you can have him here too if you don't know him.
Amen.
You're going to sing it, G.
Yeah. In God's word I read, he's building a mansion for me to move in and live someday. When from the old world, in the name of Jesus, I make my future, I'll leave behind this old house of clay. There's a mansion for me in that beautiful city. It was bought by the blood on Calvary Street. My name's been inscribed on the door of it. There's a mansion for me.
There's a mansion for me.
And there's a mansion for you. Down here on this earth, I never had a big house. Never had much chance for fortune and fame, but because of God's word and the promise he's made me, when I leave this old world, that's all gonna change. There's a mansion for me in that beautiful city. It was bought by the blood on Calvary Street. My name's been inscribed on the door. There's a mansion for me, and there's a mansion for you.
stranger. My friends and loved ones will be next door. Oh, I'll cross the street. Lives old John the Baptist. And every time I step out, I'll see my Lord. There's a mansion for me.
There's a mansion for me
in that beautiful city. It was bought by the blood on Calvary Street.
I tell you, Jesus is good to us today. Amen.
Be flat.
All you have to do is call on the name of Jesus to be saved. Amen. I got saved about 30 years ago, maybe 31. And he's always been good to me, Brother Don. Always been good to me. I'll tell you, he's a friend that'll stick closer than a brother. Amen. Praise the Lord. I have no one to blame. How I longed to hide my face. I was so ashamed of all the wrongs I'd done. And I knew I had to pay. I was bound to face hell's flame, I'd be there today. My friends, but for the blood, but for the blood shed on Calvary's tree, but for the blood, there'd be no hope for you and me. For all my filthy rags, and that's all I'll ever be. But for the blood that cleansed and set me free. Even now I get so low. You know the devil lets me know I'm so undeserving. I'm unworthy of God's love. Oh, yes, I know it's true. Here I am with the chosen few. I'll stand today. Yes, I'm saved just by the blood. But for the blood shed on Calvary's tree. But for the blood, there'd be no hope for you and me. For all my righteousness is filthy rags, and that's all I'll ever be. But for the blood that cleansed and set me free. Yes, for the blood that cleansed and set me free. Thank God for the blood. Without the shedding of blood today, the Bible says there'd have been no remission for sin.
Amen.
Well, down, praise the Lord. I'm glad down the streets of
praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Well, down the streets of Jerusalem came a funeral parade. The same lonely street Oh, came the resurrection. They moaned of a loss of a loved one. When Jesus saw their feet, he laid his hand upon them, and death had decreed. Arise, arise, my little one, arise. Arise, arise, wipe sleep from your eyes. I am the resurrection. Down the streets of glory, someday I'm gonna stroll in a land of milk and honey where the saints will never grow old. When Jesus comes back for me on that resurrection day, in my heart I'm so excited I can almost hear him say, arise, arise, my little one, arise. Payday, payday.
He moves among us, all that he does, all of his mercy and all of his love. A pen of a writer could write every day, even this world could never contain how I have been blessed. Warmth in the winter, flowers in of summer, a changing of leaves, food on my table, a good place to sleep, clothes on my back, and shoes on my feet. I have been blessed. There's
mother and father, nurtured and raised, sisters and brothers, memories made, our pastor to lead us, an altar to pray, stripes that can heal, and blood that still saves. I have been blessed.
Thank you so much, Altro Church of God from Altro, Kentucky. And we appreciate them coming tonight and sharing their songs and their love for the Lord. Their phone number to get in touch with them, 606-398-2623. And that will get you in touch with them, and they'll tell you all about their church and so forth. James from Corbin said he's really enjoyed the singing tonight and appreciates WLJC. And also Faye from Perry County, she's needing prayer tonight, but said she's homesick for this bunch, said she used to go to church with them. So I imagine they would tell you to come back, Faye, wherever you are. We have a number of prayer requests in here. Jennifer has called for her brother-in-law from Bath County. His wife passed away last night. Imogene for a son and a daughter from Dalton, Georgia. Son is having hernia surgery, and the daughter has also had surgery. Brother Cecil's down from the phones, and so it looks like you've been doing some praying up there. A lot of calls coming in.
Yeah, we've been praying for most of the calls tonight, Sister Margaret, is for people's children, and I'm smarter than that, and people's children and loved ones, you know, that's went on. They're losing loved ones right now, but you know, the most important thing we could do right now is to believe the scripture and know it's real. And I believe it's time we go to praying for our families harder than we ever have, and praying for one another. You know, as we was talking before the service, where there's two or three, he's in the midst. And you know, if you're out there tonight, you don't understand, you don't know that you got a home in heaven, I'll tell you what, it's no greater time as right now is to ask God to help you and show you the way. The Bible speaks right there in Proverbs about wisdom, having wisdom, and letting her be pleasant to you. I believe, honey, we need to know that God so loved this world, Sister Margaret, he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. You know, I'm glad we're serving a God tonight that he won't let us down. All we got to do is get through that darkness into that light. You know, we're talking about stuff holding us down. And you know, there's a lot of stuff. Unforgiveness, I've heard you teach on it. Unforgiveness and all this other stuff. We need to just to wake up right now. We're in a time. I believe we're in a season that God is reaching out to his people. All we got to do is, you know, he's standing there with open arms, and all we got to do is accept him into our hearts. And it sounds hard, but it's so easy to do. But the flesh will hang on. It won't let us unless we ask him to. And I feel the goodness. I know there's everything in the world in the way, Sister Margaret, of people getting saved, ball games and everything else. But one thing about it, he's still on the throne. And I believe that Spirit of God can come through cancer. I believe it can do all. It's a miracle maker. And all we got to do is believe that he is. the King of Kings. And I believe we need to believe that he prayed to the Father, and the Father sent that comforter on this earth. I'm still believing in that comforter, and I believe it's just as real as it was in the days when John cried out in the wilderness, prepare ye the way. You know, there's a lot of people today in the nursing home. Sister Margaret has called up there tonight and asked to, and watching it. And people watch this station, you know. A lot of 80-year-olds I talked to tonight, and, you know, they're still praising God. They're having a lot of problems, but praise God, he's right there to bless every problem we have. All we got to do is believe it. He said to believe, didn't he? I want to believe in an only begotten Son. I want to believe in that Comforter. Where we mess up a lot of times. You know, Jesus, he's alive in his spirit. Amen. I would like to have been there when John baptized him, wouldn't you? And that spirit come right down out of heaven and spoken to him. Said, this is my son and I am. You know what? We just got to believe this word. And Sister Margaret reads it before service every time. And this word is so real and so alive. And I want to just call on his name tonight and say, Lord, please heal one more. Please save one more. You know, all this stuff going on. But I believe God will take his arms and put around us and shield us if we ask him. You know, all he said to ask him, we shall receive, right? Seek him, we shall find. Knock and that door shall be opened. I'm looking for that door to open tonight. There's one more person out there wanting to be saved. There's one more person wanting to be healed. And you know, we believe it strong enough, he'll give us our heart's desire.
All right, we'll share some more of these requests. Martha has called for Jean Ann, said she had gotten out of ICU, but she has pneumonia.
Bless the Lord.
And she's back in ICU again. And also she has a neighbor that's in the hospital. From Somerset, Allie is enjoying the singers and WLJC. She needs prayer, cannot walk. From Laurel County, for Frances that lost her brother, Terry, to cancer.
Bless him, Lord.
And Marcella from Laurel County for David. Triple bypass tomorrow at Hazard is scheduled for him. Eva from Morgan County for her family. From Williamsburg for the family that suffered a great loss. Everyone heard about it on the news. And you can't understand what things like this happening.
No.
Good families that just fall apart. Mm-hmm. We don't understand this, but you know, no, you can. I heard the pastor say all you can do is call on the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
From Floyd County, pray for someone that, there's several needs in that family. Here's a great granddaughter that was born too early and can't come home because the weight won't come up. Dora from Fayette for physical needs, and also for a grandson that's 13, 14 years old that's in the hospital. Here's a lady going into the nursing home. Mary, she's sick, mm-hmm. and she's going into the nursing
yes,
home
mighty
tomorrow.
Lord.
She wants prayer for her unsaved children.
Amen.
Mike from Tennessee has called for Joy and Sherry. Essie has called for her parents that have the flu, and there's a lot of that going around, and we need to pray for Shan and Bill.
Bless them, Lord.
Shan, I think's about to get this virus that's going around, and Bill's already sick, so we sure don't want him getting it. And so anyway, we just need, you know, there's not a single day nor hour that you can think about that we don't need the Lord.
That's right, sister.
To be with us.
Amen.
And you know, sometimes this sounds like, well, this is just one time that we need the Lord. No, there's not there's not one moment in our life that we don't need him.
Good words, yes,
and
Lord.
So that's why there's, here's some from Pulaski County and Pike County, Fayette County. There's a lot of them, but you know, each one of these are really important because each person that call, they're feeling the pain.
Yes, they are.
That's like, you know, everybody's been trying to tell me how easy cataract surgeries mm-hmm. are and mm-hmm. how simple it is and everything. And I said, yes, but you're talking about somebody else's eyes, not
right,
mine.
That's right.
Now, I've really been shying away from this, but But, you know, if it's somebody else, then, you know, the pain that they have, we don't feel.
That's right.
But when it comes home, then, hey, it gets real. And that's why that we take these prayer requests seriously at night. Because some of these you might think, well, that doesn't sound like much. But yeah. It is if you're sick and not able to get through to victory for yourself. It just means a lot to feel people's prayers
yeah.
and love
Amen.
Supporting you. And it will bring a healing to you emotionally and spiritually
yes,
and physically.
Try.
All right.
You know, Sister Mark, you was talking about that. When they come at me with a knife or a needle, it's serious to me. Well, there's going to be some prayers going up, amen. But, you know, there's so many people out there, and the hospitals are full, the rooms are full. But let's come together tonight. You know, if you've never prayed, some people, I've had people tell me, even in the upper room and other places, I don't know how to pray. Well, he teaches his disciples to pray. Oh, Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. I know you're there. Lord, I know you're there. You know what, folks? These little children being born, they can't help their coming here, Brother Don. They can't help it. And we need to lift them up today. They may not have guidance, but one thing about it, it's such a privilege to people to be able to come on this station. It's so important because it's going everywhere. And, you know, the words we say is very important, and we need to teach that love more, the love of the Almighty God, and the Spirit is so real. You know what? I got to have him all the time. I've been preaching and saved for 33 years, but I got to have him because I want him. I want that protecting arm, guys, around me, and I'm right out of Buckhorn. that's where I was born. You know, but one thing about it, I've traveled all over this country, but I've never felt nothing no greater than when the Spirit of God, someone told me the other day, said, I never seen nobody get anointed like you can as quick as you can. He said he'd never leave or forsake you. You know, it's our lives that we live, and folks, listen to me, we can't be as good as we think we can, but one thing about it, the Lord can make us that way. And everybody out there, if you've never prayed, oh, Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done as it is on earth, it will be in heaven. Forgive us of our sins, for we can forgive her. You know, we need some forgiveness. Like we was praying before service. If the singers and all of us come here and shake everything off of us, all them little things just collected on us during the week, we can have church. Somebody's going to get moved up on it. Amen. Come on, somebody amen me. I have to amen myself. Thanks, Don. If you've never prayed out there in the land today, God's got a sense of humor. Folks, he called me to preach. But one thing about it, you hear me. There's nothing no greater, no greater love than you'll ever have is have that Spirit come into you. I don't need it on me. I need it in me. I don't need a touch. I need the Lord to come into my heart. And after he gets in there, then you get that touch. Help me pray tonight. If you've never prayed, let's pray for Sister Margaret in this station because there are people getting moved up on as we speak tonight. As you sang, a lot of people enjoyed that. And we want to ask them to bless that. And a lot of elders tonight. Crying out, Father, we come into your loving name. Oh, we know all time belongs to you, but Lord, we're going to ask you right now, glory to God, to bless one more lost person. We're going to ask you, Lord, in a loving way to heal one more. Lord, you're still healing. There's still miracles. There's no difference. The works you've done, we can do also in greater works, Lord. I can feel a good spirit connecting here tonight, and I know it's you. Lord, there's people being saved. There's people being healed that we don't ever hear of. I'll just have them call in, Lord, where we can rejoice with them. And Lord, we're lifting our children up. We're lifting our country up. And we're most of all, we're lifting you up, Father, because you're the King of kings and the Lord of lords. We'll never fail to praise you in Jesus' loving name. Amen.
Amen. All right. Thank you so much. We do need to be praying for our nation. There's as long as there's breath, there's
yeah.
hope, and so we can believe for the Lord to turn things around, and once again, this be a praying nation. And
yes,
I believe
Lord.
There's a lot more people praying than we hear about.
Coming
now,
back,
what
Sister Martin,
what
more
you
more.
Hear on seem like in the news a lot of times is just the bad things, and it takes up all the news time.
That's right.
But
that's
there
right.
is a lot of good things happening. That doesn't get broadcast. And so we need to seek out those things and share them and to encourage
Amen.
Ourselves and to encourage others that we're we're not alone in believing the Lord to do something for our nation. And
you're switching it around, right? You're telling the good news, and the news is telling the bad news. Amen. Glory to God. That's good. Hallelujah.
Because our stories never change.
That's right. That's
and,
good.
And but the news today, what you heard today, will be old tomorrow.
Yeah,
and they have
that's
to
right.
have something
that's good.
Else.
I like it.
But I like it because Jesus said He is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Yeah.
And that gives us such security.
Oh
see?
Yeah, we need it.
And oh, we've got to see things happen for Him. And when we put Him first, He's promised to help.
Yes, amen.
All right. Once again, thanks to the Altro Church of God from Altro, Kentucky, for being here tonight. And now, you know, each one of these churches, they might be small, but if they're praying for WLJC
amen.
And its outreach, well, you know, that is, that's being a friend. And so we appreciate that.
Amen.
And so it looks like our time has come and gone for another night. So we'll be back before long. So from all of us, we're going to say good night and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. WLJC is now available on Roku and Google TV. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including the Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed about what is happening at WLJC, along with our monthly musical guest schedule, call 606-464-3600 or write to WLJC, P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Want to hear from us faster? Join our email mailing list. You can sign up at wljc.com. It's easy and it's free. May God bless you.